We're talking about the tragic murder of Mark Nicholson, 51 years old, in the 3400 block of Liberty Heights Avenue. It occurred April 17, 2015 at 3:30 a.m. And Detective Jeremy Sobert and Lieutenant Jerron Jackson are here in studio. Why don't you introduce for us Mark's sister, who now joins us on the air?
Sure. On the phone joining us is Mark's sister. I've had the opportunity, unfortunately, under these circumstances that you never want, to get to know her just a little bit. And we're very grateful that she was able to join us today on the phone.
Good morning, and first of all, give us your name, and my prayers and sympathies are to you. Please, go ahead, please.
Hi, so this is Mark's sister. First of all, can you all hear me okay?
I can hear you fine.
Okay, so I just want to, first of all, thank you all for having me dial in today and be able to focus on Mark's case. I mean, the main things that I want people to know about him is that he was a really good man, a family man. So, you know, the family is just really still, you know, reeling from his murder. He was hardworking, just as Mr. Silbert alluded to. He worked a full-time job. He had a plumbing business. He rarely took any vacation time or anything. He focused on family more than anything. So if he had any free time, that's what he spent his time doing. So that wasn't just with his children, but that would be with his grandparents when they were actually living, his aunts, uncles, cousins, friends. He stayed in contact with everybody, and I always personally admired him for that. I mean, everyone loved Mark. So he was just always willing to help his relatives out if they had a plumbing problem or needed anything fixed. He was a man of his word, and so you didn't have to follow up with him. Once he told you he was going to do something, he did it. And he just, you know, as a matter of fact, if you followed up and said, hey, are you still going to do this, he would get annoyed with you. Just say, I told you I was going to do it. And the one thing I remember is that for him, you know, he didn't have a lot of patience for foolishness or, you know, things like that. His famous words, if things were getting on his nerves, it was just, you just say, I'm out. So that's what I remember about it. It just makes me laugh thinking about it. He had a really great sense of humor. I think, you know, he just spent his time, he just loved to talk, hang out, and crack jokes with his family. His first love was boxing. Muhammad Ali was probably his greatest.
There you go.
You know, sports hero. So he loved the Ravens, of course. And he loved old cars like GTOs and Cadillacs, old stuff. And we just always found that interesting that, you know, he just wasn't, you know, in awe of new and glossy things. He liked classic things. So I would want to also share with everybody, you know, when we were growing up as kids, our family wasn't really good into telling people, you know, how much they loved you every 5 minutes. But as Mark grew up and became a man, he actually changed the game on that. And I think in my experience, he's probably the first person to actually say, I love you.
Wow.
And so he wouldn't wait for a special holiday or birthday to tell you. He always told his family and his friends how much he loved them.
Well, Detective Silbert, if I might, just for a second, I don't want us to run out of time. I would really like for you, if you could, and we've asked the different family members who've joined us, this is C4, to just make an appeal to the community for them to come forward and share whatever information they have so we can bring to justice the person that took your brother.
Yeah, so I'm just saying, at this point, we know that the Metro Crime Stoppers is offering a $2,000 reward to resolve what happened in his case, and the family is in the process of contributing an additional private donation of $23,000, making the reward $25,000 for any information that leads to an arrest and conviction. So we're in the process of doing that right now. So I just would encourage anybody, if they have information, to give us information in this case. I mean, just to have him taken away so violently is just, you know, it's just mind-blowing how this happened. And, you know, it's just a really surreal feeling. And we need the people who did this or involved in this, they need to be off the street. And so I would just encourage you, if you have any information, to call and provide that information to the police.
So people often ask us, what can I do to help? Mark Nicholson, he was killed in Northwest Baltimore. We might have someone listening in Southeast Baltimore right now out of the area that says, listen, I wasn't there that night. I didn't see anything. I didn't hear anything. I want to help. What can I do? And that's why this is so important for us to come on, for you and your listeners to allow us to come on and tell these stories. We would ask anyone with information, of course, to call the Metro Crime Stoppers phone number 1-866-7-LOCKUP. People can also log on to your website, WBAL.com.
Yes, all the information is there.
You put that up. But we would also ask people to follow us on Twitter and Facebook. We posted everything on there. It's as simple as clicking in this new age we have with electronics and social media. Retweet the information that we're putting out there. Share it on Facebook and help us get Mark Nicholson's story out there.